Hey guys, it's me, Jaren, back again with another video, and today we are going to be talking about Cosmic Garou versus Saitama, the best new gen anime fight of all time. Gojo versus Sukuna. Sukuna had too much plot armor. Gojo was thrashing him the whole fight just for Sukuna to somehow come on top after a 3v1 and still losing. Ichigo versus Yawa? Nah, just no. I can't think of how the two would compare. Not in terms of, you know, writing, not in terms of the power, the fighting, all of that. I can't see it. But yes, the best new gen anime manga fight of all time. Part 2. I'm going to probably have to make this into a 3-to-4-parter. The last time I recorded this, this is my second take. It was 27 minutes long. 27 minutes. So, if you guys do enjoy and you guys want to see a part 3, part 4, I don't know how long this is going to take me. I want these videos to at least be like, I want this video to be at least like 20 minutes maybe. 20 minutes at the maximum, because this is probably going to be very long. But yes, if you guys do want to see other parts, please hit the like button and subscribe. Thank you guys for the recent support on the last video, 760 views, over 34 likes, and gained 10 new subs from that. Welcome to the Baller Squad, my fellow anime fans. But without any further ado, let's get into chapter 164, the beginning of it all. So the chapter starts out with Lightning Max talking to the other heroes on how they have to get to the shore and go find Tario, because Tario went to go talk to Garou. Then this kid sees a drowned dead body when it's literally just Pig God with the other heroes in his mouth. And then Garou is getting pissed off. And I mean pissed off, I'm talking. He was crashing out. This is probably one of the craziest crash outs in anime manga history. This is a crash out on multi-dimensional planetary levels, bro. Like, so then we get Garou, you know, throwing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20 punches. Literally 20 punches at the same time. I just counted. And Saitama, hey, that's pretty sweet. Where'd you learn that trick? Wasn't I supposed to become absolute evil, is what Garou thinks to himself, after Saitama effortlessly dodges his attacks after before. He just got faster, stronger, more durable, and just give it up already, is what Saitama then says to this guy. He slapped him away with one hand. Keep that one hand in mind, my beautiful viewers. To all the people watching this video, remember, one hand. That's enough, right? Garou getting pissed off, thinking about how he saved those civilians. He then hits Saitama with an attack that solos not only Fairy Tail, not only Naruto, and One Piece, probably even the Seven Deadly Sins verse 2 is not surviving this attack. He hits Saitama with an extreme Fajin. These panels are beautiful. Murata, I need to meet Murata the day before I die or he dies. I need to meet him at all costs. Like, look at these panels. I'm gonna put all three up at the same time. These panels are just the art. There is no better art style than this. Berserk is the only one that actually somewhat comes close, but this art is just Then we get the scale of the attack. It literally causes an entire continent on the other side of the planet to come up. He attacked the core of the planet Earth. After that, he did not only just bring an entire continent from onto the other side of the planet, it caused spatial distortions on a multi-dimensional level. That's why that one attack solos those four verses. None of their attacks were capable on a base level. They're not even he's not even attacking the dimension on purpose. He caused an attack on dimensional levels just by pushing Saitama into the Earth. But yeah, Saitama just looking at Garou, bored, tired of his BS, heck, I would be too, hits him with a consecutive normal punch, which sends him flying right back out of the mountain. And then Garou's just thinking to himself, my techniques, my speed, my power, my creativity, my attacks, how the hell am I supposed to take this guy down? You don't. To destroy the abominable fist that turned against God, the monster God, is what Sage Centipede said to Garou. He thought he was talking about him. Buddy, you were wrong. It was Saitama. Bam! Punches him through two different mountains. The speed and power you can feel with every punch is just... Sorry, my back hurts. A lot. Then Garou's just getting sent flying like he's a skipping stone. And then Garou's thinking to himself, he's like the embodiment of unfairness. And then he says, there's no way I'll let myself lose to him. Bam! Bam! One-shotted. One normal punch to the face. Get sent flying. In that panel, the one that started it all. So even after I've made it this far, it figures I get pulverized by this unbeatable unfairness, and now it's all over. And then he speaks to him.
I can hear you.
Saitama says to himself, at first a lot of people thought, oh wait, Saitama hurt him? What? Saitama has some sort of dimensional power? His power didn't come from working out? No. Saitama's a gag character. His gag is that he did such a simple training routine to the point where he was just capable of literally one-shotting a large, large percentage of most of anime. Okay. So, no. He doesn't have some sort of higher dimensional power like a lot of people like to theorize, as in the next chapter we literally see in the next panel we literally see just talking about the clouds. Lightning Max says, what's up with that cloud? As all the heroes, everybody's looking at the clouds, as God's feet, the One Punch Man God, the monster God's feet, go into the clouds. Now, at first, a lot of people thought, oh my gosh, they can see him? And then the next panel, we get confirmation that they can't. And then Saitama, once again, he can't see, further proving that he doesn't have any multidimensional power at all. And then that man speaks to him. Garou, who are you? Your deepest wish is to no one will to fall apart as fertility at the hands of a single hero. Huh? Shut your mouth. You want to get killed? Garou says to Garou.
There is only one fist that can counter the fist that is turned against God. What do you think that is?
What are you trying to say? Who the hell are you, asshole?
Show me your face.
And I'm here trying to help you out. Old man, there is no master who could just sit back and watch his students get to be. Come. Pause. And then we get the panel of Bang being imitated and Garou shaking his hand.
And boom, something's coming, is what Saitama says as we get one of the coolest transformations, the cleanest transformations, and the most beautiful, the best, in my opinion. This is the best manga panel ever. No manga panel. You will have to send me the manga panel in the comment section to tell me what is better. You cannot tell me there is a better manga panel than Cosmic Garou for the first time. You can't. You can't tell me. Look at this. He has six different galaxies in his body. Now, this is very fitting considering this fact that he's gained human cosmic abilities. And he has the destructive capabilities and the attack potency to destroy that of an entire universe, said by Murata himself. So yeah, it's very fitting for the character at this point. Saitama was wondering, what's up with your face, Garou? So, and then Garou starts talking to himself,
something that can count on the fist that has turned against God. I guess that'd be the fist of God.
And then Saitama says, sounds like he's talking in a bathroom or something. I am going to try to edit in like that bathroom talk. I'm just going to try to edit my voice in a way where it sounds like I'm talking in a bathroom. But yeah, and then we get Garou imitating Bang perfectly. Awaken Garou, Cosmic Fear Mode. Peak fiction, guys. At the time, guess what was trending on Twitter? One Peak Man. Not One Punch Man. One Peak Man. Then we go into chapter 166 with them talking about how Garou's abilities and whatnot are so, like, good, and how he can copy things so well. We get Bang, and then we get Garou's fight with Bomb, and then we get another amazing, beautiful panel of Garou swirling a galaxy in his body. Now, this is actually very important. Garou here is literally trying to branch out to another universe where Saitama loses. That's what's actually going on here. This is Garou trying to go back in time, look for a point in time where he could beat Saitama, but he can't. That's why Garou knows the technique to go back in time in the future. Sorry for the spoiler, but it's just so... And then we get the all-life eradication fist. Nuclear vision. Oh man, this is just, like, at this point, just look at every panel that I'm putting up on. Then we get Psycho's fine-looking self toted up saying, those are the same... homeless emperor's energy spheres, divine power, they're so massive. Anyways, we get five mushroom clouds proving that Garou's attack not only is very strong, it's nuclear, meaning the powers that he actually copies isn't just the copy, it's literally exactly like the original, the same thing. And then we get a amazing, beautiful gif. I'm gonna put it on the screen for you guys. Murata is just, he's actually trying to open up his own animation studio too, which is really cool. I think at the end of this chapter, or no, the end of next chapter, we might have to end the video there because this is getting really long. Then our boy Genos knows that Saitama's in there fighting. Then we get Saitama complaining about his outfit and whatnot. And then Saitama literally says, "You just sound like a bad guy," right before he gets instantly stomped. There's a lot of panels, a lot of mistranslations saying, "Garou, I feel like I can do anything." It used to be, "I feel omnipotent." There was a lot of mistranslations back then with how fast people were trying to get the chapters translated. But this is the actual translation. Unlike the last one saying subspace gates, all that, I got hurt, all of those mistranslations. These are the right ones. Then Garou goes into detail about his modes. And then he does this one move, the one move that proves that he solos 95% of anime by himself. Mode Saitama. He can do this for any character he wants. Mode Luffy. Don't know why he would do that, because he's already weaker than him in his base form. Mode fucking Beerus. Mode Anos. Mode anybody. He would still lose in Mode Anos, obviously, because Anos is literally just built completely different. Mode Rimuru Tempest. Like, at this point in time, now with chapter 201, the redraw, Garou at this point now, and a lot of One Punch Man characters and whatnot, actually do scale to Rimuru Tempest at this point, so that's cool. So now at this point, Garou could literally just go mode Rimuru Tempest, and would probably come out on top. But yes, he does mode Saitama, and then throws consecutive normal punches. Then Saitama and Garou clash for the first time in this entire fight. And it's amazing. They trade blows. Saitama gets a little bit of Garou's exoskeleton on him, but people think it's blood. Dumb, dumb, dumb people. Both of them jump out of the water. And then Garou's like, "You're at a loss for words." And then he starts being cocky and whatnot. And then Saitama says in the proper translations, "And I made a big deal to that kid that I wouldn't hurt you." The mistranslations all the Goku fans like to use, saying that Saitama, "Oh, and I made a big deal to that kid that I wasn't going to get hurt." Like, they've gone to new heights. They made whole websites to translate this just to say that he took damage. It's not that deep. But yes, he's talking about, "Oh, I'm standing on the same endless horizon of power as you. Still concerned about that brat that he's literally nowhere near him." And then he hits Saitama with the Gamma Ray Burst. Thank you, Murata, for the explanation. A Gamma Ray Burst is an explosion that occurs at the end of the life of a massive star, and it is the largest and most powerful explosive phenomenon that has ever been confirmed in the universe, behind the Big Bang. The Big Bang, once again, just a theory. But, fun fact, did you know gamma ray bursts can actually travel thousands of light years away? Meaning it's, on the high end, a galaxy level attack. But yes, we get another insane, beautiful panel of the aftermath of the gamma ray burst. I mean, I just can't stop with Murata, bro. I can't. Oh, man. And then we get Garou landing in, and we get the biggest moment, the biggest aura moment in anime manga history. There is no character that has more aura than Garou. You cannot name another character with more aura than Garou. Literally, every panel up until this point, Garou has aura. The manga literally says, "The symbol of fear that brings all heroes to despair, absolute evil." He literally has aura that kills people. I know it's radiation and whatnot. That's just deadly aura. I don't care if it's cosmic radiation or whatnot. That's just deadly aura. He literally is making them run away in fear. But yeah, he thanks the monster god. Bang tries to talk to him, and he's like, old man, so you're still breathing. And he tries talking to Garou and whatnot, and come to his senses, and said, I've always had my... He said, I heard you say thank you, did a monster do something to you? And he said, not really, I always had my senses. He smacked the One Punch Man God's hand away. He wasn't trying to accept his power. As if the old man would act like such a softy.
Even if you didn't fully take my hand, you did just touch.
He gave him the smallest amount of power he possibly could at that point in time. The smallest amount of power. We've seen what Cosmic Garou can do. Imagine what this cosmic being right here can do. Imagine. Like,
I shall make you my avatar. As for what you do with that power, you already know that fully well.
The multidimensional monster god says to Garou. And he literally nearly lost consciousness to the intense flow of power throughout my body, is what he said. We can see as the galaxies form in his body and whatnot. And then, old man, you once taught me something, to feel the flow of energy and become one with that flow. That is the power of the water stream, he said. I've become one with the flow and succeeding in controlling it. I am truly grateful. He literally has become one with the flow of all energy. I managed not to turn into that thing's weird puppet. And that's why, from here on out, what I do is of my own. Whatever you say, man. Whatever you say. Then he says, sorry, Taria.
This is goodbye. Time to confine.
As all these heroes start running away. The ones that can still move and still run are trying to run away. Once again, one of the biggest aura moments of all time. That is that evil aura right here. That is that aura that produces fear in the hearts of his enemies. It's just insane. But yes, now it is the end of the video. 23 minutes long.
Why are you complaining? You're not the one that had to sit here for 2 hours straight trying to get this video edited and done before tomorrow, me. Okay. And actually, perfect timing. I gotta go real quick. If you guys did enjoy, please hit the like button and subscribe. I love you guys. Now, we'll see you guys in part 3. Bye.